So if you have been paying attention to this whole Umar Johnson saga, you might be familiar with Don. He is Umar Johnson, ex-employee. He said Umar Johnson owes him $3,000 for work he did on the property in Wilmington, Delaware. The last I heard on this matter was that Don filed a lawsuit and the sheriff was trying to serve Umar Johnson. While Don is back on the scene, he is now going by the name Don M, the FDMG boogeyman. And he said that Umar Johnson was finally served on September 10th. If we look at the docket on the Court Connect, .courts.delaware.gov website, we can confirm that Umar Johnson has been served. Personal service return as to Umar Johnson on 9/10/2021. In the video I did titled My Message to Don, Umar Johnson, former employee, I said if I solely relied on what Don said and the text message communication between him and Umar Johnson, he is owed money. In a recent live stream, Don said a few things I want to discuss. I would first like to say I am not a lawyer and this is not legal advice. One of the things that Don said is that someone offered him $8,000.
You didn't know about the $8,000 they offered me, right?
Nah, I hadn't heard nothing about that.
See, that's what I'm saying. But nobody on the good guys going to do lives on that because, you know what I'm saying, that was I don't know why they did.
I mean, did other people and the good guys know about it?
That shit was on. Everybody was on the chat. Everybody's on the live. Okay, that shit was lit. Okay. That's what I'm saying. Where was you at that time? That shit was lit. It was there. They was supposed to take it. They was like, "Don't take that. Don't take that." I was like, and once I saw them say, "Don't take it," I was like, "Fuck it. I ain't fuck with that. But nah, fuck out of here." I was already saying, "Fuck out of here." But then they was like, "How much? How much? $8,000." I was like, "Damn, I need that."
Okay, I was about to ask you that. In hindsight, do you feel like you should have just took the AGs or the
No, I'm not no cheap nigga. I'm a king. That nigga violated me. I already told y'all. He violated me. That $8,000 was a bribe out. And then once I understood what it was, I was like, nah, okay. So if I can do $8,000, I know I can triple that shit in the courts.
Links to the full audio of all of the clips in this video can be located in the video's description. Okay, I don't know the whole situation behind this $8,000 that was offered to Don, but here is what I will say. If this was offered to Don as a settlement for the $3,000 he's claiming that Umar Johnson owes him, he should have accepted it, and here is why. If we look at the docket, we see the case type is breach of contract.
I believe that they won't have a problem putting a lien on that building if he don't respond. I believe. Why? Because, like I say, I fill out the paperwork and I believe I got the side of the courts. They did it. They pulled off a miracle and got him served. And that within 2 days after I went back to court, I was like, yo, what's up? Why my paperwork not done? And 2 days they got that served on that Friday. So I already know that they won't have a problem putting a lien on that abandoned building. That someone would love to be a school, but it would never be his school. And so a person might say, well, how are you going to put a lien when you don't even, he don't owe you that much money? Well, with pain and suffering and all that other stuff, and like they say, punitive damage and all that other stuff.
In the audio you just heard, Don mentioned punitive damages. But here is the thing. Punitive damages are generally not awarded at all in breach of contract cases. The same goes for pain and suffering and emotional distress. Those are generally not applicable in a breach of contract case. Now, if he said no to the $8,000 and proceeded with the lawsuit for $3,000 as a matter of principle and to get his day in court with Umar Johnson, I can understand that. But from some of the things that Don said in the past and what he's saying now, he feels this situation is going to yield him a windfall. Don also said the max is 15.
So I watched one of your lives and you said that the settlement was up to 15K now.
Yeah, because the court that went through, so it's the maximum is 15. So the max I can get out there is 15G.
What he's referring to is $15,000, which is the max you can ask for in a small claims case that is filed in Delaware. Based on the docket report, we know it's a breach of contract case. But I have not seen the paperwork laying out Don's claims. However, based on what he's saying, he seems to be asking for the max compensation. So if Umar Johnson answers the lawsuit, the burden of proof is going to be on Don to show how Umar Johnson owes him $15,000. Because based on the text communication between him and Umar, he is owed $3,000. Now, if Umar Johnson doesn't answer the lawsuit, Don will get a default judgment. Another thing Don mentioned is putting a lien on the property if he prevails in this lawsuit and Umar Johnson doesn't pay. I think he might have an issue putting a lien on the property. If we look at the docket report once again, we see Don Murray versus Umar Johnson. This property is technically not owned by Umar. The property is owned by Frederick Douglass and Marcus Garvey, RGB International Leadership Academy, Incorporated. Since a corporation is a separate entity, I think in order to put a lien on the property, he would have to get a judgment against FDMG RGB International Leadership Academy, Incorporated. But based on the docket report, he is suing Umar and not FDMG Academy. But what do I know? I am not a lawyer, and this is not legal advice. I am just providing commentary on the situation. Here is what we do know. It doesn't look like there is going to be a default judgment because on October 15, Umar Johnson answered the lawsuit. So it's going to be interesting to see how this whole thing plays out.